Good morning, dear children. Let us start the class. Today we will do the remaining part of the workbook, that is the chapter time. Okay, the topic for today is estimate time, and today we will be completing the estimate time, and in the next class we will be doing the rest of the question, that is the practice question from the same chapter. Okay, so let us start the class. So children, the topic for workbook is estimate time. Okay, so let us start the question. The first question is, a week is shorter than a, we know a week is shorter, not shorter than an hour or a day or a minute, because a week has got 7 days. Okay, so it is shorter than a month. All right, the next question is 0620 in the morning is written as, if it is morning, the answer will be AM, the option number D. 11:45 at night is written as, okay, so at night it will be PM. Okay, so 11:45 at night is just written as 23:45 hour. Okay, 23:45 hour. This is not correct, because in PM we don't write in 24 hour format. All right, children. The next question is duration. That's a formula. Duration equals to end time and start time. This end time minus of start time. Okay, option number A. The time we must know to find the duration of an event is start time and end time. Both start time and end times are required to know the duration. So it is both A and B. The start time is 9:45 a.m. and the duration is 1 hour. What is the end time? Okay, so according to the formula, we have to find the end time. So it starts at 9:45. After 1 hour, what will become? It will become 10:45 a.m. Remember, children, it might look confusing here. Both a.m. and p.m. is there. So you have to be careful, because in the question it is a.m. The next is start time equals to end time minus duration. We already got that. End time equals to start time plus duration, and duration equals to end time minus start time. Okay? So children, in the next class we will be doing about the practice questions. So these are the questions from the workbook today. It is the estimate time. Okay? So everyone, you can write. I'll send a PDF file of the answers also. You can write it down in your workbook. The next question is, Soumitra went to school at 9 a.m. He returned home after 3 hours. What time did his clock show when he got home? Express your answer in the 12-hour format. So Soumitra went to school at 9 a.m. and he returned after 3 hours. So we have to add and we have to express the time in 12-hour format. So this is hour and this is hour. We got 12. In the minute, nothing is there. So we'll write 00. Pratika woke up from sleep at 10 in the morning. Denote the time using AM or PM. So she woke up 10 in the morning. If it is morning, then it is AM. If it is night, then it is PM. The start time of a maths class is 10:30 AM and the duration is 1 hour. What is the end time? So this is also similar to this. Okay, so 10:30 AM plus 1 hour, we got 11:30. Remember the children, it is AM here, it will be AM here. But if it is cross 12:30, then it would have become PM. Okay, you have to remember that. Question number 13 and 14 you have to do yourself. Let us go to the next question, that is 15. Kiran start cooking at 11:20 AM. He cooks for 1 hour 50 minutes. He then takes an hour to bake cakes. What will be the time when he finish cooking? So Kiran started cooking at 11:20 AM. He has done two things. First, he cooked for 1 hour 50 minutes. Then he started to bake a cake. What will be the time when we'll finish both the tasks? Okay, so start time of cooking is equal to 11:20 a.m. He started at this time. Duration to cook is 1 hour 15 minutes, 50 minutes. And the duration to bake is equal to 1 hour. So the end time will be 11:20 a.m. plus 1 hour 50 minutes plus 1 hour. Since it has crossed 12, the answer is 2:10 and it will become p.m. Okay, question number 16. Leela usually takes 1 hour 15 minutes to complete her homework, while Shashi takes 1 hour 30 minutes. They both start working at 6:30 p.m. that is in the evening. At what time will each girl finish her homework? So Leela and Shashi are two friends and they have started to do their homework at 6:30 p.m. in the evening. Okay? And Leela takes 1 hour 15 minutes and Shashi takes 1 hour 30 minutes. Now both started at the same time. We have to find the time in which both had ended their homework, have finished their homework. Okay, so the start time of homework is 6:30 p.m. and the time to finish to homework. Okay, Leela had to finish his homework, her homework by 1 hour 15 minutes. She took 1 hour 15 minutes. So we will add 1 hour 15 minutes with 6:30, we got 7:45. That means Leela finished her homework at 7:45. On the other hand, Shashi took 1 hour 30 minutes. Okay, so Leela took 7:45 p.m. She's finished her homework at 7:45 p.m. And Shashi took 1 hour 30 minutes, that you add with 6:30 p.m. We got 8 p.m. Okay, so Leela finished her homework at 7:45 and Shashi finished her homework at 8 p.m. Okay, so both the time is almost similar. It is the difference is of 15 minutes. The next question is, Seema went to the railway station to see off her aunt. There she saw that the departure time of the train to Delhi has been changed from 1110, that is 11:10 hours, to 3 hours later. What was the change time for the departure of the train? Express your answer in the 12-hour format. Okay, so the new departure time is 11 hour 10 minutes. Okay, and plus 3 hours later, that will we got 14 hour 10 minutes. Now 14:10 hours is less than 12. The given time is p.m. Okay, so what we have to do? We have to subtract 12, okay, from the hours, and the minute will remain same. So what will become? It will become 2:10 p.m. Okay, change time 11:10 hours to 3 hours later, and we have to express in 12 hour format. Now this 14 is less, that is why we have subtracted. If it have been more, then we have added. Okay, since 14 is bigger than 12, 12 is less than 14, the given time is p.m. Okay. The next question, question number 18, you have to do yourself. 18 and 19, you have to do yourself. The next question is, Jaffer took part in an essay writing competition which was for 2 hours. The competition started at 8:30 a.m. If Jaffer completed his essay 20 minutes before the end time, at what time did he complete his essay? Okay, so time for the essay competition was for 2 hours. Okay, and the start time is 8:30 a.m. Okay, and the competition has to end by 10:30, isn't it? 8:30 plus 2 hours, we got 10:30. But Jaffer completed his essay 20 minutes before. Okay, so 20 minutes before 10:30 a.m. is 10:10 a.m. You can do here one thing also, 10:30, you subtract the minute also. Okay, minute. So how much we got? 10:10 a.m. Understood? The essay competition was 2 hours and it started at 8:30 a.m. So we know that it will end by 10:30 a.m. But he finished 20 minutes before. So at what time he exactly finished his essay competition? So it will be 10:10 a.m. You can subtract minus 20 from 10:30, what you will get? 10:10. Subtract the 20 not from the hours from, but from the minutes. Okay, question number 21. Dharmendra's vacation started on 11 December and ended on 20 December. For how many days was his vacation? Okay, so his vacation started at 11 December and end time we got 20, this end date. Okay, end date we got 20 December. What is the duration? So according to the formula, it is end time minus start time. Okay, so 20 minus 11. Why we have added 1? In the live class also I told you that when we subtract 20 minus 11, we will get 9. But if you count from 11, okay, his vacation started from 11. His vacation didn't start from 12. His vacation started from 11. So 11 till 20, if you count one by one, you will get 10 days. That is why we have added 1 here. Okay, so 9 plus 1 equal to 10 days. Question number 22. Diksha's test 1 started on March 17 and continued for 5 days. She appeared for the first paper of test 2 on April 5 and the last paper on April 11. How many days did it take to finish both the tests? Okay, so start date of test 1 is March 17 and the duration was 5 days. Okay, March 17 it started test 1 and it continued for 5 days. That is the duration. Now test 2 started on April 5th and it lasted last paper on April 11. So it started from April 11 till April, it started from April 5 till April 11. Okay, so April 11 minus April 5 plus 1. We already know why we have added 1, because we don't subtract the number, first number, or we don't subtract the last number. Okay, see, 20 minus 11. Okay, so 11, when we count from 11 to 20, we get 9 days or 10 days. But if we subtract, we'll get 9. So that is why we have added 1 here. Similarly, here also we have to add 1. Because if you count 1 by 1 in a calendar, you can see from April 11 to April 5th, it will be 7 days. So already test 1 was 5 days and test 2 is 7 days. So number of days to finish both the tests is 5 plus 7 equals to 12 days. So Disha completed, how many days did it take to finish both the tests? 12 days. That means Diksha's test was for 12 days. Okay. So children, in the next class we will be doing about the practice questions. So these are the questions from the workbook today. It is the estimate time. Okay, so everyone, you can write, I'll send a PDF file of the answers also. You can write it down in your workbook.